In a country that tells us that separate is inherently unequal, in a year with a pandemic that has laid bare the inequities that Black and brown children have to face, why is there another obstacle to success? Why do we allow for overtesting?
The test itself is racist and is a form of segregation. The test is not fair, nor does it have diversity. Why wait another year to get rid of it?
Meryl and Brianna, just two of the strong voices in the Teens Take Charge campaign, convincing the city's mayor-appointed education panel to rebuff the mayor in an 8-7 vote and get rid of the gifted and talented testing this year.
The lack of Black, Latinx, and Indigenous representation in the gifted and talented programs across the city in the year 2021 should be an abomination to all of us.
Teens Take Charge project manager Taj Sutton is a former New York City gifted and talented student. She saw firsthand how gifted students reap the benefits that the majority of New York City public school students will never see. COVID-19 only furthers the invisible barriers to academic excellence, where poor families don't have access to test prep or technology, and English language learners don't have interpreters. There are only 2,500 available seats out of 65,000 kindergartners.
The education system we have now only places value on certain kinds of students. So that child who's an amazing engineer but bad in English and math, where is the place for them?
The assumption is gifted kids are well-behaved and hardworking, and general education students are not. These teens are demanding that culture stops, and the city's Department of Education listens to the students they're supposed to serve.
Because it was a student who is deeply impacted by an inequitable system asking all of these adults to do better.
The city still has not announced a plan for this coming year, and it's unclear how admissions for the gifted and talented program will move forward. Calorama, PIX 11 News.